Today, I will show you how to do cleanup and color in OpenToons that will turn your animation from this to this. So, let me just get back into the laptop and show you how to do it.
Oh, so here we are again at the start screen of OpenToons. First and foremost, let's load the animation we've made in the previous video. So, in order to do that, you can just find the file on the right-hand side. But if it's not there, click Load Scene and it will open another window. So, you can just open it from where you saved the file. By the way, if you're new to my channel, if you like to follow step by step, I suggest you pause this video first and watch the previous tutorial where I introduced the interfaces of OpenToons software and how to create a rough animation. Just click the eye icon at the top right. Okay, if you've watched the previous video and you're ready to proceed, let's go do this. I actually did some homework and created a character to use as a reference. If you like to download this image, I will put the link in the description below. So I want to import this image into OpenToons so I can look at it while I'm doing cleanup and color. In order to do that, we can click and drag the image into OpenToons. A window will pop out asking if you want to load or import the file. What is the difference? Well, to import means OpenToons will create a copy of the file onto the folder where it usually saves. This is helpful if you're transferring the files on different computers and you can find the files easily. To load means OpenToons will load the file from its location and it will not create a copy of the file. I usually just use load because I pretty much just use one computer and I know where it's saved anyway. Besides, creating a copy of the file means it will consume extra space in the hard drive. And there we go, here's our reference. I'm just gonna move it to the side so I would be able to see what I'm drawing. The next step is tie down. Tie down means adding details to the animation roughs. So let's create a new level on column 3. I'm gonna name it jump-jumpman-td because tie down dash 1 in case we need a number 2. We're gonna use the same setting as the roughs and we're gonna use the Toons raster layer. I want to lower the opacity of the rough animation so I can see the overlapping drawing better. To do that, select column 1 and if you notice there are two icons there. Click the arrow beside the icon with a pinkish background and a slider will pop out where you can adjust the opacity. I'm just gonna adjust mine to 50. Alright, let me just speed through this tie down process. While this speed drawing is going, I just want to tell you the difference between cleanup and tie down. In tie down, you're pretty much just sketching the details onto the rough animation. You can still make mistakes at this stage, but I would suggest trying to make the character on model as much as you can here as it will save a lot of time in the next process. Cleanup is what it is. It's cleaning up the drawings, which means the lines have got to be clean and crisp. You're prepping it for colors already so you can't have sketchy and wonky lines. This is also the stage where you have to fix the mistakes you made in tie down and make the drawing more appealing. The character has to be on model at this stage. One tip I can give is that you keep checking the previous frame to ensure the proportions and the overall drawing is consistent. Flipping between the previous frame and the current frame you're working on will allow you to see if the object is animated properly. This will also save you a lot of headaches once you proceed to clean up. Whew. Here's what we have so far. Let's play it in a loop to see where we at. Ah, look at that. It's starting to come along together. Okay, let's do the cleanup. Let's create a new level on column 4. I'm naming this one jump-jumpman-cu because cleanup, dash 1 in case we need the number 2. Before we draw anything, let's set the palette first. We're going to use the eyedropper tool to get the character's color from the reference image. However, if you notice, there are two eyedropper tools. I will be discussing the difference between these eventually, but for now, we will be using the second eyedropper tool called the RGB picker tool. It's a little bit tedious, so bear with me here. Right-click on the palette window and select new style, then select the RGB eyedropper and click it on the part you'd like to copy the color. Let's do the line color first. So I'm clicking anywhere on the lines and it will be copied on the palette. You can also rename this by double clicking the name. I'm naming this one outline. Now we have to do the same process to get the colors of the skin, jumper, etc. Alright, here is the entire palette of the character. I did rename all the colors to avoid confusion. The next thing we need to do is export this palette so that we can reuse it on different levels, just in case. On the bottom right, you can see there is a disk icon. Click that and the save window will appear. Feel free to name the palette however you wish. I usually save the palettes on the palettes folder in OpenToons so I know where to find it when I need to load it, but feel free to save it wherever you want. Now the moment we've been waiting for, doing cleanup. I don't need the rough animation anymore so I'm gonna hide it by selecting column 1 and clicking this eye icon with an off yellow background and the circle thing icon with a pinkish background. The eye icon will hide the column on the final render and the circle thing icon will hide the column on the canvas. Then let's just lower the opacity of column 3. Let's go back to column 4 and do the cleanup. So select the brush tool and set the appropriate thickness and adjust the smoothness to your preference. While this is going, let's talk more about the X shape, especially the columns. Think about the columns as layers like in Photoshop or Clip Studio. One thing you have to keep in mind is that the rightmost column will always be the topmost layer. You can arrange the order of the columns by clicking and dragging the column. By the way, I just found out about this, but you can change the column name by double-clicking the column. So you can label the columns however you like. Okay, let's stop this speed drawing here for a bit because I want to show you how to duplicate drawings. What do I mean by this? In this example right here, frame 7 and frame 8's drawings are almost identical. And while we can copy and paste this, it's easier to extend the frame, right-click, and choose duplicate drawing. And what it does is create a duplicate of frame 7. The difference is that when I edit this duplicated frame, the previous frame will not be affected. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. One tip I would like to give is to make use of the rotate and zoom tools. It's very helpful, especially in drawing clean lines. In my case, actually, my hand is more comfortable in drawing curves that arc towards the right-hand side. But when I do curves arching on the left, it's less appealing, so I use rotate tool to put the drawing in a better position for me to draw the lines better. Another thing I would like to point out is that you don't have to strictly follow the tie-down because when doing clean-up, the main priority is getting the character on model. When I work in a studio, I've received handouts where the animation tie-downs aren't exactly on model, and it was quite a headache because I got tons of revisions because I followed the tie down too much. So don't just blindly trace, make the drawing better and make it on model. Alright, here's the cleanup drawing. Frame 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Let's play it to see how it looks so far. Awesome! Now we're almost done. The only thing left are the colors. The main tool we'll be using is the Fill tool. Fill an area with a color, select a color in the palette window, and just click around the area you'd like to fill. For starters, let's fill the skin first. We're gonna do this to all 15 frames. I usually fill the drawings one color at a time, so in this example right here, I'm filling the skin for all the drawings before proceeding to the clothes, etc. For me, it's faster to do it this way because you don't have to move your mouse all over the place to change the color and fill. You only need to change colors when you're finished filling one part of the drawing for all frames. One thing you have to look out for is the gaps within the line because the fills can mistakenly leak out of places you don't want that specific color in. So just double check your drawings just to make sure. The fill tool is great for filling in large areas, but it's not a perfect tool. If we zoom in right here, you can see there are some very small unfilled parts. To rectify this, we are going to use another tool called paintbrush tool. Not to be mistaken with the brush tool. I know, it's very confusing. So the paintbrush tool is like a fill tool but freehand. So instead of clicking on the area you'd like to fill, you have to draw freehand to fill something with color, which is really good for nooks and crannies like this because it won't draw over the lines like the brush tool does. So you have to do this on all the frames. Double check any corners for any unfilled gaps and fill it using the paintbrush tool. Here we are, guys! We've created a full colored animation. Let's play it in a loop to see what it looks like. Ah, beautiful.
Now you know how to animate frame by frame, but did you know there's another way to animate in OpenToons? So if you click this video right here, I will show you how to do it.